All right, guys, hope y'all are doing well today. It's good to see you. And what I wanted to talk about today was actually aftermarket suspensions. We had a lot of guys write in and ask us to do something on the available aftermarket suspensions, and there are so many of them, there's just no way I'm going to cover all of those for the Falcon, Fairlane, Torino, Mustang, and Maverick, and also the Mercury line with Cougar, because a guy asked about Cougars, Montego, and also the Comet, because the Comet was used on the earlier cars, and then it was also used on the Maverick-based cars. And Ford also did that with the Falcon and the Falcon, because the early Falcon was in and of itself, and the later Falcon was based on the Fairlane. Anyway, after the break, we're gonna be talking about performance suspensions for your midsize and small Fords. Check it out.
Autocrafters, your source for Falcon, Fairlane, full size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford truck, Cougar. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
All right, now what I'm going to talk about here is I'm going to talk about the four major styles of suspension that are available in the aftermarket for your small pony car and midsize Ford and Mercury. Now, it goes as follows. You have a stock style tubular upper and lower control arm system. Now, that basically has a mimic to the original style, but a lot of those guys are making huge changes to the control arms to make them work in the classic car. It still has the coil up on top of the upper A-arm, and there are systems that you can do a coil over on top of the A-arm to make that system even a little more modified than it originally is from the aftermarket factories. All right, next up is a double A-arm coilover system. Now the coil spring runs down through the upper A-arm onto the lower control arm and has a shock absorber built into it and ride height adjustability built into it. I'm going to talk about all that here in a minute. Both of these systems are non-invasive. You're not going to have any changes to the chassis that will affect it if somebody, say, wants to go back and do a complete bone stock restoration on the car. Not sure why that would happen. Most people don't do that, but a lot of guys want that ability to be able to go backwards whenever you can in order to fix things. Next up is the Mustang II. Now, this one is a complete departure. With the Mustang II, you're looking at the system that was on the 1974 to 78 Mustang and on the Pinto, in fact, from 1971 to 1980. This system is completely different than what you would have on the car. The thing about it that's kind of a little bit disconcerting to some folks is the fact that you are going to have to weld this system in. You gut the entire shock tower assembly and everything out of the car, and then you put the Mustang II in, and it's a weld-in setup. But the big advantage in that system is it guts the complete engine bay of shock towers. You have as much room as the width of your inner aprons to play with for engine applications in the car. Guys who are doing twin turbo setups, things like that, the Mustang II might be a really good solution for you to put into a car because the packaging on it is just so much better than you'll get from the stock style setups with the SLA control arms on those cars. Finally, we have the McPherson Strut system. Now, the McPherson Strut system is a nice setup. It lacks a control arm completely, and it, with the shock tower notching kits that are available from the manufacturers that are doing this, you can go in and put most aftermarket engine applications into the chassis. If you want that wide, big 429 Boss or a 5.0 Coyote and a classic midsize to small Ford, guess what? You can do it with the McPherson Strut system. And a lot of these guys even have mounting kits that will allow you to do that with ease in the chassis. It's a nice little way to do things. Now, what I'm going to talk about now is features that you need to look for in these systems. The first one I'm going to deal with is the standard basic unit, which is the tubular control arms with the coil on top of the upper control arm. Now, in these systems, what you're looking for is you're looking for A, you want it to already have the Shelby drop done to it, and then B, you also want it to have about 3 degrees of positive caster already built into the system. That way you're not having to do any of the stuff that we talked about in the last episode on how to set that up and get that positive 3 degrees of caster that you want to have on the front end of the car. Another thing you want to look for in those kind of systems is for it to either have a rollerized bushing setup or something like a aluminum and polyurethane that has a greasable zerk fitting on it so that it has a lot of free motion to it. I'm a big proponent of free motion in the front end on these cars. And then finally on that front, you'll want to have it so that you could put the rollerized spring perch on top of it, or try to buy one that has a rollerized spring perch and then go in with a double adjustable shock absorber on there so that you can get a non-gas shock to go in it, because basically you're still dealing with a stock front end. Things are a little different with that, but they are still running under the same principles. Now, what we're going to talk about is the coilover AA arm system that you get from a lot of these guys, the one that has the coil running all the way through it. Basically, everything that I'm talking about with the other one applies to this one as well, and so you want to make sure that you have all of those components plus a few other cool items that you want to look out for. You want to make sure that it has a double adjustable shock, one for damping and rebound, like the other unit has, as well as an adjustment on the coilover for ride height. Most every one of these systems has that, but it's a key factor that makes this a nice, cool system, because you can then go in and finite adjust the front end for ride height to whatever you think you need it to be, and then go out and get the front end aligned by whatever shop you want to have it aligned by. Some of these systems also have a setup so that you can adjust the upper control arm for when you're dropping that thing. You may want to be able to put more out for more camber on it or whatever. The more adjustments that one of these coilover systems has, the better off you're going to be whenever you go out and actually, you know, start driving the car, because the more adjustments there are, the more you can do with the front end. Also, on both of these systems, the cool thing is that you can use your original spindle and disc brakes. So in other words, if you've already invested money in your disc brakes on the car, these two systems will allow you to reuse all that stuff and not have to go out and spend even more money on disc brakes. Now, on the Mustang II, you're gonna want that double adjustable shock again for damping and rebound, simply because you're gonna wanna be able to go in and fine tune that system. You also may have to go and look for a set of spindles that are a drop spindle for this application, because you may get the thing done and have too much ride height in it. And sadly, the Mustang II is just not that cool for ride height. Also, one of the cool things about it, as I've said before, you can put any engine you want in a Mustang II. You're open all the way out to the inner fenders on it, so if you want to do a big block 429, you're good to go there. The other nice thing is almost every Mustang II kit comes with a rack and pinion from the factory. The rest of these don't. They don't have rack and pinions with them. You have to buy the rack separately, not as part of the kit. So when you buy a Mustang II, you should have everything there, from brakes to rack and pinion, and then you have the thing that you have to install, which that's kind of a downside. You have to install this, and it is invasive into the chassis. The rest of the stuff that we talk about here, none of them really are invasive. The Mustang II is the only one that you're going to have to go in and really do modifications to the car. So if you've got an original style car, maybe with a big block 428 Cobra Jet, it's an R-Code Mach 1, and you want to handle and perform better, the other three kits are going to be your best bet, because you can go in and put them in, and then if you go to sell the car, you can take everything out and put it back to stock, because you'll probably get a little bit more money for the car if it's got the original stock components on it. Though that's kind of changing now as time's going on. Now finally, we're going to be talking about the McPherson Strut. This kit is basically like a modern car front suspension. It's pretty much the same stuff that the 04 GTO ran back then. Now, I know that that's a while back, but we're still talking about more modern than anything else in our list here. So that is the basics of what the idea was behind this type of system. You're looking at a front end that has all the thought processes that went into the McPherson Strut system in 2004 on a lot of these cars. Like I said, in particular the 04 GTO. So a McPherson Strut, what you're looking for in that is the ability to go in and make all kinds of adjustments. You should be able to adjust position of the strut. You should be able to adjust ride height. You should be able to get a single or double adjustable shock on it for damping and rebound, as I said before. And it will be a nice running system. It camber changes really nice. I kind of like this one just simply because it's also non-invasive, unless you want it to be. Then what you can do is go in and cut the shock towers out of it and put any engine you want in the chassis, as I've said about that kind of stuff before. Now, what I will say is that there are some limitations on that, but with this system, in a Fairlane especially, and even a Falcon, you can go in and notch the shock towers and get a 5.0 Coyote to fit, And with some of the things these companies offer, you can actually do that, move the brake system inside the car to get away from the problem of having the valve covers on the 5.0 invade into the space where your brake master cylinder should be. Always a problem. You can go, you just can't stop. But with the system, the way they have it designed, they have a setup that you can do to move that booster inside the car and clean up that firewall and not have that issue. All right, finally, my thoughts on all this, such as it is. I think there's merits to all systems. If you're on a budget, I think that the tubular control arms with some of the modifications that they do to them, if you do what I'm talking about in my features section there, you'll find yourself with a really nice control arm system that's going to perform better than a stock system, certainly. But you're going to not get as much as you would from, say, a coilover system or the McPherson Strut or even the Mustang II. The coilover systems are really good. They've been around forever. The coilover has been available on the classic car line since probably 97, 96. So they've been making those for a good long time, and they perform very well to the tasks handed to them. Coupled with a rack and pinion, they'll actually go around a racetrack pretty darn well. The Mustang II was created, has been used in the street rod industry since pretty much 1974. As soon as they figured out that this thing would fit in a classic chassis, guys were using them on street rods. Guys have been putting them on C10 Chevy pickup trucks. They are everywhere. And the nice thing is you can do anything you want in the engine bay on a car that has this stuff on the front end. Is it a road course suspension? I think it can be, but typically it's not. Typically you're going to do this on a car that's going to be more of a straight line car, or a car that you're going to do a big engine and a small chassis and just wow your friends with it. It can go around a road course quite adequately. I don't see them a lot in road course use. It's not that they can't do it, I just don't see them doing it. The final one, the McPherson Strut system, a really nice system, used a lot in Australia. There's a company down there that does those, and they put them on the road courses down there. There's another company here in the States that does them. They road course the piss out of them too. They're a good running, good handling suspension. Like I said, they do have a couple of caveats that can happen, that I've seen happen, but overall, they're a great running system. I would pick any one of the four of them depending on what I'm doing. It's kind of like having a drawer full of correct knives. You have a knife for this, a knife for this, a knife for this, and a knife for that. That's how I see it. Well, that's our show for this week, folks. Do me a favor, leave a comment in the section below. I know this is kind of a broad brush, but that's what I really wanted to do. I want to get you thinking about it, not necessarily focusing on things. Understand that I am not going to sit here and give you guys names of companies to go to, because quite frankly, there's enough of them that are good enough out there that you need to go out and do the research and find out what you need for your car. Remember, it's like I've said before, focus on what your 90% on your car is. If 90% of the time you're going to be taking the car and just driving it around, maybe a set of tubular control arms is just for you, especially if you're like me and a bit of a raccoon and you like the bling. Because as a raccoon, you gotta have the bling. I don't know. In any case, like I said, leave a comment, give us a thumbs up, give us a thumbs down. Let us know what you think of things around here, what's going on with this, if you like this little series we've been doing. Also, let us know if there's things you wanna see. If you do wanna see another install, we've done a Streeter track. The link to that one is right down here and in the description below. And we've also done a Mustang II a while back from Rod and Custom Motorsport. That's right here and in the link in the description below. So there you go. My thoughts on aftermarket suspensions. I know it's very broad brush, but sometimes you just gotta go broad brush to kind of get the juices flowing so people start thinking about what they need to do. In any case, folks, you guys stay safe, stay well, and we'll see you on down the road. Oh. This video was a bear. I know it doesn't look like it was a bear, I hope, but I'm gonna tell you right now, so many takes, so many problems, and it's just me sitting on a stool talking to you guys like I would if we were sitting in the shop and you guys were answering questions and asking questions of me. Sometimes it goes like that around here. So you have those kind of things happen. Part of the problem is I'm working by myself. One of the takes I had, the mic wasn't on. I don't have anybody behind the camera right now because the kids are on spring break. Now here in South Carolina, we're still doing the COVID-19 thing. We are going to go on lockdown as of 5 o'clock today. They have a stay-at-home order because nobody in the state of South Carolina knows how to pay attention. To just stay at home, you have to tell them to stay at home. So we're on lockdown, but we have been camping this week. Good Lord. We have a lot behind our house that's empty, and the kids put a tent up out there, and we have actually been camping on this empty lot. There's trees and all. It's like it's a forest. Kids love it. I think it's the greatest thing since sliced bread. We even had a buck come through. There's a lot of wildlife in our area. We had a buck come through the night before last and scared the piss out of everybody because he was screaming for a mate. You can't make this up. I even grabbed the 38. I thought, this is it. Apocalypse now. So anyway, folks, there you go. That's a little bit of behind the scenes at the end of the video. If you're still watching, love you. Have a great week. As I said before, don't do anything I wouldn't do, which knows that needs to open for a whole lot of stuff. Out!